Everything is perfect now. See? That was a good bream. See how that bream was feeding, just took like a mouthful and went off again. That's like a classic bream feeding, you know. During the daytime, they just take a mouthful and then they are off. They take a mouthful. Roach, leave my hook bait, please. See those roaches, they are so annoying. Once they get the hook bait off the bottom, it's so difficult. Bream is coming, can't see my hook bait now. And I got a bream on. Okay guys, I'm putting a couple of feederfuls of food, and as you can see, it's insane amount of small fish in here. Another one. Let's wait like 20 seconds and then I'll shake it off. But as you can see, it's insane amount of small roach, mostly just ridiculous. Okay guys, first cast. Here is my maggots. Just look how many perch I have now. Ooh. Bream, 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 bream. Can I got him. When it comes to the rig, it could not be any simpler. Basically, I have about meter long shock leader made out of 0.30 fluorocarbon. Then I have about 10 centimeters twisted loop here, and I have a simple double blood knot here, and also I have size 8 Preston Stutz shot, and then I have size 12 swivel with a carabine. And there I have attached my feeder, which is 10 gram Drennan microfeeder. Then there is loop to loop, obviously, where I attached my hook link. And the hook link is 0.13 fluorocarbon. Then the hook is size 14 Guru Kaizen. So very, very simple tactics. How about that for a shot? That pike is showing off really, and small roach just kind of following that pike behind, from behind, insane. Awesome television guys, really, really awesome. That's my feeder. My hook bait just landed behind the camera. I will drag my feeder just a touch so you'll be able to see the hook bait. Here it is, perfect. Yeah, right now everything is set up very nicely. You can see the hook bait perfectly and the feeder as well. So yeah, I will stop filming, and once I will see the bream in the shot, hopefully I will turn the camera on, and then, you know, maybe we will catch that bream as well. As you can see, I have a little bit of bait now in my bag. So let's see what will happen. You know, my maggots are just on the, our hook bait is just on the right there. Roach are coming back in numbers. Some perch will find my maggots, I'm sure of it. No, just went past them. Great. Okay, let's wait. When it comes to the ground bait, as you can see, that's a bright yellow Bream mix sends us one sweet and nice, not super fine mix for bream. Beautiful. And on the hook I'm putting just 3, 4, 5, 6 even maggots, just like that. As you can see, I'm filling my feeder nice and compact, just like that, ready to go. As you can see in the shot, I have the feeder closer to the camera and my maggot just a little bit further, still almost in the middle of the shot, which is really, really good, you know. If the bream will come, I should be able to see that fish quite well, actually. Anyway, let's wait and see. Also, as you can see, the sun is poking out now, so it's brighter now. Not sure whether the bream will like that or not. Time will tell. See? I actually can't believe the bream is coming. It was... I will catch that fish. Did you see that? Just pass through. That was epic. That was epic shot, guys. Perch is looking. Come on, perch, go away from those maggots. I want that bream. That bream actually looked at the maggots, I think, and then at the feeder. It will be back, I'm certain it will be back, guys. So exciting, so exciting. Plenty of roach, mopping everything up. But that was classic. I mean, all the bites from the bean were classic, you know, today. And during the day, just bream feed like that. They are off the bottom most of the time, and then they kind of dip down to kind of scoop something, you know. What is happening here? Can't see my maggots now. So roach, I'm just, look, can't see anything. Can't see my feeder. Now can see my feeder, and my maggots are still in good place. Awesome. Very likely some bream is feeding just off the shot, you know. Some big perch is trying to eat the maggots. And I did see some indications actually that perch moved the feeder a little bit, but my maggots are still in a good place. My maggots are a little bit out of focus now, but still you can see them just like almost in the middle, just to the left of the middle, you know. But that perch definitely moved them. What is that? Something was trying to eat my maggots. Is it a perch? No, but that fish left those maggots, which is great. That perch will give it another go. Not sure. Just looked at those maggots. Still looking at the maggots. Ridiculous. Come on, perch, go away. Yes, that perch. See, that perch kind of went like 3 times around those maggots. Another one just looking at the maggots. I cannot believe how many times that perch tried to eat the maggots. Really ridiculous. Another one is looking. So perch, as you can see, they are almost protecting the maggots. Probably we'll have to move those maggots a little bit closer to the camera. Now they are a little bit too far, I don't like that. Let's see if we can do that. Nice and steady, little pull. Yeah, perfect, now it's good. Here's my feeder, let's drag it a little bit closer. Can't believe some small fish grabbed the maggots just on the drop. Let's drag a little bit closer those maggots and the feeder. Not sure if I can. Oh yeah, I can't see them in the shot. Perfect now. What was happening there? Some perch likely attacked those maggots, but they are in a good position now. Some perch is just hovering above the maggots. Perch is looking at the maggots, leave them alone. I got that perch. No, spat out, cannot believe. My maggots are just at the corner of the shot there. I mean, not ideal position, but should do. Roach have returned. Can't see my maggots now at all. Oh yeah. Yeah, actually they repositioned them again into the shot, like out of the shot, into the shot. Insane. Some bream is coming. See, that bream tried to eat the feeder. If I would had, you know, like a metal feeder, likely I would have hooked that fish, very likely. Bream is coming for the feeder again. That was ridiculous. That was ridiculous. Can't see my maggots. Where are my maggots? That bream is... I will catch that bream. See? It's trying to eat my feeder. That's ridiculous. Obviously, that's a very like big fish and small feeder. That makes sense. But where are my maggots? Can't see my maggots now. Wow, that bream is... That's it, I got him. I just saw a bream before I started recording, actually. But I think that fish was feeding, kinda. So it might return, you know, to the shot, I hope. Everything is perfect now. See? That was a good bream. See how that bream was feeding, just took like a mouthful and went off again. That's like a classic bream feeding, you know. During the daytime, they just take a mouthful and then they are off. They take a mouthful. Roach, leave my hook bait, please. See those roaches, they are so annoying. Once they get the hook bait off the bottom, it's so difficult. Bream is coming, can't see my hook bait now. And I got a bream on. See, that's a decent slab, guys. Right, the boat is coming through. As you can see, it messed up the peg properly. You can't see anything. So yeah, I think it's time to call it, guys. Hope you enjoyed this short video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.